Good morning, children. Sai Ram. So, after a long time, we are meeting in the science class, right? So, welcome back to our science class. Okay, children. So, we have learnt this chapter number 14 before the Pongal holidays, right? So, just we recall what we have learnt in this lesson, okay? And we'll just read the lesson. And we will do some book back exercises. Okay, children? And the remaining we will do in the next class. Okay? Shall we? Okay. So, the title of the chapter is The Sun, Moon and Stars. Sun. So, what are all the things we have learnt about the sun? So, the sun is, it is a star. Okay, it is a star and it is the brightest object in the space. Okay, so we get heat and light from the sun. Okay, children? And it is a very huge ball of hot gases. And we have learnt the sun's family. Yes, so the sun has 8 family members, right? 8 planets. So, the planets, what do you mean by planets? So, it is a object, the huge object that goes around the star is called a planet. Okay. So, there are 8 planets revolves around the sun. Okay. So, the sun has 8 planets revolves around it. And our Earth is also one among these 8 planets. Okay. So, the sun and these 8 planets belong to solar system. Okay. So, these are all the things we have learnt about sun. The next one, moon. So, stars. Yes. Next, we have learnt about stars. Right. So, during the night time, we can see lots of twinkling stars, right? So, in ancient days, people used their imagination. How? So, they used to connect the stars to form some shape or pattern in the sky. And this imaginary pattern is called constellation. Okay, this imaginary pattern is called constellation. And stars did not have their own light. Okay. And the next one, moon. Next one, moon. So, this is the nearest neighbor in space to our Earth. Okay. It is the nearest neighbor for our Earth in the space. Okay, children. And we have learned the phases of the moon, right? What are the phases of the moon? The new moon, crescent moon, half moon, gibbous moon, and full moon. And in how many days the new moon will become crescent moon? And after how many days it will become half moon? So these are all the things we have learned in moon. Right, so we shall read the lesson once, okay, and we shall read the important points from the lesson and we will do some book back exercises, okay, and the remaining we will do in the next class. Okay, children, so you can read along with me. Okay, shall we start? Yes. So the title of the chapter is The Sun, Moon and Stars. The sun is the brightest object in the sky. It is a huge ball of very hot gases. It gives heat and light. Without heat and light, there would be no life on the earth. The sun is a star. It is the star closest to the earth. Okay. The sun's family. A planet is a huge object that goes around a star. Planets do not have their own light. The sun has 8 planets that revolve around it. The earth is one of these planets. The sun and its 8 planets belong to the solar system. So this is the solar system. Okay. The next one, stars. On a clear night, you can see thousands of stars twinkling in the sky. All stars are huge balls of hot gases. In the olden days, people used their imagination to connect several stars to form a shape or a pattern in the sky. These groups of stars forming an imaginary shape or pattern in the sky are called constellations. Okay. Constellations have been named after animals or people from ancient myths. The great bear, Orion, the hunter, Leo, Canis Major and Hercules are examples of constellations. Okay, so this is the picture of great bear and this is the picture of Orion and this is the picture of Hercules. The next one, the moon. Look at the moon. The moon is a ball of rock that revolves around the earth. It is our nearest neighbor in space. It has no light of its own and is lit up by the light from the sun. When the moon goes around the earth, different parts of it are lit by the sun on different days. We see the part that is lit up. So it looks as if the moon changes its shape every day. When the moon is between the sun and the earth, the side of the moon facing us does not get sunlight. So we cannot see the moon because its dark side faces us. This is the new moon. After a day or two, we see a small portion of the moon. This is called the crescent moon. After 7 days, we can see half the moon. This is the half moon. So after how many days we can see half moon? 7 days. Okay. 2 or 3 days later, we can see more than half the moon. This is called the gibbous moon. Okay. 2 weeks after the new moon, the moon is on the opposite side. The side facing us gets sunlight. We can now see the full moon. The different shapes of the moon as seen from the earth or called phases of the moon. Okay, so these are all the phases of the moon. Okay, it takes the moon nearly 28 days to go around the earth. So the number of days between one new moon and the next is 28 days. Okay, so what are the important points we have learned from this lesson? The sun is the star nearest to the earth. The second one, the earth and the other planets revolve around the sun. Third one, the sun and its eight planets belong to the solar system. The next one, an imaginary shape or pattern in the sky formed by a group of stars is known as a constellation. The moon is a ball of rock that revolves around the earth. The moon has no light of its own. It shines when sunlight falls on it. We can only see the portion of the moon that receives sunlight. This is why the moon appears to change its shape every day. Okay? So, now we shall do some book back exercises. Okay? So, first one, multiple choice questions. Okay, multiple choice questions. First question, which of these is a star? Which of these is a star? And the options are sun, moon, earth, Orion. So which of these is a star? Sun. So sun is a star. So the correct answer is sun. Okay. Second question, which of these is the biggest in size? Which of these is the biggest in size? And the options are Earth, Moon, Sun, Mercury. So which of these is the biggest one? Of course it is sun. So the correct answer is sun. Okay, sun is the biggest in size. Third question, which of these is not a constellation? Which of these is not a constellation? And the options are Orion, Moon, Leo, Great Bear. So which one is not a constellation? Moon, right? So other things are constellations. So moon, the answer is moon. Fourth one, on which day after the new moon do we see the full moon? On which day after the new moon do we see the full moon? Options are day 3, day 14, day 18, day 7. Which one is correct? So after the new moon, 14th day we can see the full moon, and after that for full moon, 14th day we can see new moon. Okay, so after new moon, from one new moon to next new moon, there will be 28 days. Okay, between two new moons there will be 28 days. Okay, so after new moon, on 14th day we can see full moon. Okay children, the next one, fill in the blanks. First question, the sun gives dash and dash to the earth. The sun gives dash and dash to the earth. So what do we get from the sun? So we get heat and light, right? So the sun gives heat. Heat and light. Heat and light to the earth. Okay. Second question. The earth is a dash. The earth is a dash. The earth is a planet. Okay. The earth is a planet. Okay. The earth is a planet. Okay, children. Third one. The sun and its dash planets belong to the dash system. The sun and its dash planets belong to the dash system. So we have learned this sentence in this lesson, right? The sun and its, how many planets are in sun's family? 8 planets, right? The sun has 8 planets that revolve around it. So the sun and its 8 planets. 8 planets belong to the dash system. Solar system, right? Solar system. The sun and its 8 planets belong to the solar system. Okay. The next one. You cannot see the moon. This is the last question. Okay. You cannot see the moon on dash moon day. You cannot see the moon on dash moon day. Whether it is new moon or full moon or crescent moon or half moon or gibbous moon. On which day we cannot see moon? On new moon day, right? On new moon day. So you cannot see the moon on new moon day. Okay, children. So have you all understood? Have you all recalled the concept? Yes, the important points. Right? So the remaining exercise we will do in the next class. Okay? Okay, children. So read the lesson again and again. Okay? So that you can understand on which day it will come new moon day. And after how many days we can see full moon. And after how many days we can see crescent moon. Okay. So if you read the lesson only, you can answer all these questions. Okay, children. So read the lesson again and again. Okay. So they have given in picture very clearly. Okay. So you can look at the pictures and you can read the lesson again and again. Okay, children. So study well. I'll meet you in the next class. Okay. Thank you.